Okay, so this gets us to our next hemolytic anemia, that is thalassemia. That is thalassemia. First point, you very well know that both the hemoglobinopathies, sickle cell anemia as well as thalassemia, both of these, they are autosomal recessive. You know this. Next point, thalassemia, it is of two types. Let's make a flowchart. Alpha thalassemia, it is of two types, alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia. Alpha thalassemia, beta thalassemia. In alpha thalassemia, alpha chain production, in alpha thalassemia, alpha chain production is reduced versus beta thalassemia, in which beta chain production is reduced. Very obvious. Alpha thalassemia, alpha chain production is reduced. Beta thalassemia, beta chain is reduced. You know that the predominant hemoglobin is HbA, that is alpha 2 beta 2, that is the predominant hemoglobin. So I can safely say in alpha thalassemia, beta chain is precipitated. Alpha 2 beta 2, so beta chain is in excess. Hence, in alpha thalassemia, beta chain is precipitated versus beta thalassemia, in which alpha chain is precipitated versus beta thalassemia, in which alpha chain is precipitated. Next point, genetically. Next point, genetics. Genetically, alpha thalassemia is associated with deletions. Alpha thalassemia is associated with deletions versus beta thalassemia, which is associated with point mutations. Versus beta thalassemia, which is associated with point mutations. And the most common point mutation associated with beta thalassemia is IVS, intervening sequence 15. बच्चे इसमें यू डोंट हैव टू थिंक एंड अप्लाई योर माइंड व्हाट वी मीन बाय इंटरवीनिंग सीक्वेंस. IVS, IVS, इट स्टैंड्स फॉर इंटरवीनिंग सीक्वेंस. इट स्टैंड्स फॉर इंटरवीनिंग सीक्वेंस 15, हैज टू बी रिमेंबर्ड. देर आर फाइव पॉइंट म्यूटेशंस इन बीटा थैलेसीमिया. दीज फाइव पॉइंट म्यूटेशंस अकाउंट फॉर 98% ऑफ द केसेस. सो मोस्ट कॉमन IVS 15. अदर्स आर 619 बेस पेयर डिलीशन, 619, 619 बेस पेयर डिलीशन, IVS 11, IVS 11. नेक्स्ट फ्रेम शिफ्ट म्यूटेशन 89 एंड फ्रेम शिफ्ट म्यूटेशन 41, 42. These are facts, has to be remembered, has to be remembered. This is factual information. The point mutations associated with beta thalassemia, most common being IVS 15. Next point. So what we have seen till now is thalassemia was of two types, alpha thalassemia, beta thalassemia. Next, this starts us with hemoglobin patterns in thalassemia. Hemoglobin patterns in thalassemia. Let us first start with alpha thalassemia. Alpha thalassemia, you very well know that normally in adults we have two main hemoglobins, HbA and HbF. HbA is alpha 2 beta 2. HbF is alpha 2 gamma 2. Sorry. HbF is alpha 2 gamma 2. In alpha thalassemia, alpha chain production is reduced. Now, alpha chain is needed in both HbA as well as HbF. So, it leads to the formation of beta 4 and gamma 4. In the RBCs, there should be four globin chains only. So, it leads to the formation of beta 4 and gamma 4. Both beta 4 and gamma 4, they are physiologically useless in nature. they are physiologically useless in nature. What is the role of RBCs, globin chain? What is its role? RBCs have to take oxygen from the lungs and give it to the peripheral tissue. So if these beta 4 and gamma 4 RBCs, they are not able to do so. So they are physiologically useless. And secondly, beta 4 is called as putter double star, HBH, versus gamma 4, which is called as hemoglobin parts. Very commonly asked. Easy to remember, B and B do not go together. So beta 4 is HBH, gamma 4 is hemoglobin parts. This is hemoglobin patterns in alpha thalassemia. Next point. This gets us to hemoglobin patterns in beta thalassemia. Again, there are two main hemoglobins, beta thalassemia. There are two main hemoglobins, HbA and HbF. HbA is alpha 2 beta 2. HbF is alpha 2 gamma 2. You know this. In beta thalassemia, beta chain production is reduced. So, HbA reduces, whereas HbF increases. HbA reduces, whereas HbF increases. This was the same thing which we saw in hemoglobin electrophoresis also. So, I can safely say, predominant hemoglobin in thalassemia major, predominant hemoglobin in thal major is HbF. Predominant hemoglobin in thal major, HbF. These are the hemoglobin patterns in thalassemia, alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia. Next point. This gets us to the genotype phenotype correlation in thalassemia. What do we mean by this? Genotype is the genetic structure versus phenotype, which are clinical features. Meaning, what will be the genetics associated with which clinical features? Genotype, phenotype correlation in thalassemia. Let us first start with beta thalassemia. First point. You very well know beta thalassemia inheritance pattern, autosomal recessive. Both the hemoglobinopathies, sickle cell anemia as well as thalassemia, autosomal recessive. Next point, the wild type allele. First tell me, wild type means normal hai ki abnormal hai? Normal. Wild means normal. Please do not think that civilization is normal, wild is abnormal. Nahi bache, wild is normal. The wild type allele is beta. Whereas the abnormal alleles are beta 0 and beta plus. Abnormal alleles are beta 0 and beta plus. Do not be under the misconception that beta plus, that is beta chain is increasing, so this is good. Nahi bache, it's an abnormal allele. So, as you know that beta thalassemia is autosomal recessive, so three things can happen. Either the person will be normal, each gene locus has two alleles, normal will be beta, either he will be normal or he will be heterozygous or homozygous. We have seen the same thing in genetics also. In autosomal recessive inheritance, either the person is normal, heterozygous or homozygous. Heterozygous means one allele is normal, the other is abnormal. So heterozygous is beta beta zero or beta beta plus. Heterozygous, one is normal, the other is abnormal. Versus homozygous. Homozygous, where both the alleles are abnormal. That is beta zero, beta zero, beta plus, or beta zero, beta plus. Both the alleles are abnormal. So heterozygous, homozygous. This is the genotype. Coming to the phenotype. If one is normal, the other is abnormal. Heterozygous. Heterozygous is thalassemia minor. Heterozygous state is thalassemia minor. Versus homozygous, both the alleles are abnormal. This is thalassemia major. This is thalassemia major. This is the genotype-phenotype correlation in thalassemia. What will be the genetics associated with the clinical features? Genotype-phenotype correlation in thalassemia. Next point. Now, this was beta thalassemia. Before we go to alpha thalassemia, let us have a look at few questions. Father HbA2 3.1%, mother HbA2 4.9%. Risk of baby to be thal major. Answer 0%, 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%. These are your options. 0, 25, 50, 75, 100. Answer. What will be your thought process? Dekho bache. Normal HbA2 is 2 to 3.5%. You know this. You also know that if HbA2 is more than 3.5% but less than 8%, it is thalassemia minor. This you know, we did this in hemoglobin electrophoresis in our subtopic sickle cell anemia. You know this. So what the examiner is telling you is father is normal whereas mother is thalassemia minor. Mother is thalassemia minor. Thalassemia minor genetically means she is heterozygous. Genetically, it means she is heterozygous. One allele is normal, the other is abnormal. So, in autosomal recessive, one parent is normal, the other is heterozygous. What percentage of kids will be homozygous? We saw this in genetics. Thal major, homozygous. What percentage of kids will be homozygous? 0%. How? Father was normal. Father is beta beta. Mother is heterozygous. Beta beta zero. So the kids will be beta beta, beta beta zero, beta beta, beta beta zero. So what percentage of kids are homozygous? None. So thal major, as a result, I can safely say thal major will be 0%, versus carrier state or thal minor. These two are thal minor, will be 50%. This is genotype phenotype correlation in thalassemia. Next, let us do one more question. Father HbA2 4.1%. Mother HbA2 4.6%. Risk of baby to be thal major. Answer. Same options: 0%, 25%, 50%, 75%, or 100%. Answer. Dekho. Father more than 3.5%, thal minor, that is heterozygous. Mother is also thal minor. This is an autosomal recessive inheritance. You know this. So, in autosomal recessive, both the parents are carriers. Risk of baby to be thal major, that is homozygous. The options are beta beta. The kids will be beta beta, beta beta 0, beta beta 0, beta 0, beta 0. So, what percentage of kids are thal major? 25% thal major. What percentage of kids are the carrier state? That is thal minor, 50%. Thal minor, 50%. Normal, 25%. This is genotype phenotype correlation in thalassemia. Next, so what we have done till now is genotype phenotype correlation in beta thalassemia. This gets us to our next part, that is genotype phenotype correlation in alpha thalassemia. First point, alpha thalassemia genetically is associated with deletions. We saw earlier also that beta thalassemia was associated with point mutations, alpha thalassemia with deletions. Now, normally, all of us, we have four alpha chains in our genes. That is alpha, 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 alpha. This is the normal genotype. Alpha, 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 alpha. This is normal genotype. Alpha thalassemia was associated with deletions. So, deletion of one alpha chain. Genotype, minus alpha, alpha, alpha. One alpha chain is deleted. Minus alpha, alpha, alpha. This is an asymptomatic carrier state. This is an asymptomatic carrier state. Deletion of one alpha chain. Next, deletion of two alpha chains. Genotype, minus minus alpha alpha, or minus alpha minus alpha. This clinically presents as thal minor. Next, deletion of three alpha chains. Deletion of three alpha chains. Genotype. Minus 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 alpha. This presents as, put a double star, HbH disease. When in our genes three alpha chains are deleted, phenotypically or clinically it presents as HbH. Remember, HbH was beta 4. That is, when in our genes three alpha chains are deleted, in RBCs it leads to beta 4. Genotype phenotype correlation. And last is deletion of four alpha chains. Minus 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 minus. This is Hydrops fetalis. This is Hydrops fetalis, which is lethal in utero, which is lethal in utero if transfusions are not given. Lethal in utero if transfusions are not given. If transfusions are not given. This is genotype phenotype correlation in alpha thalassemia. Genotype phenotype correlation in alpha thalassemia. Next point. This gets us to screening tests for thalassemia. This gets us to screening tests. Screening tests for thalassemia. Screening tests for thalassemia. First point. We have already seen this. Screening test of choice for hemoglobinopathies. Let it be any hemoglobinopathy, sickle cell anemia or thalassemia. Screening test of choice is hemoglobin electrophoresis. Please don't forget this ever. Whenever the screening test of choice is asked for hemoglobinopathies, hemoglobin electrophoresis. Next, another screening test for thalassemia is NESTROF. Another screening test is NESTROF. OF is osmotic fragility test. In hereditary spherocytosis topic, we did osmotic fragility testing in extensive detail. We saw that we incubate the RBCs at varying concentrations of sodium chloride. We have seen that. So NESTROF is naked eye, single tube, red cell osmotic fragility test. Naked eye, single tube, red cell osmotic fragility test. What we mean by this is, in osmotic fragility testing, we were putting numerous number of tubes. Remember 0.9%, 0.7, 0.5, 0.3 and so on. In NESTROF, we are just using single tube. We are looking at hemolysis by naked eye and we are using a single tube. Now, which concentration will we use? You know, thalassemia shows shift to left. Please have a good look at this again from the topic hereditary spherocytosis. We saw shift to left was seen in sickle cell anemia, thalassemia and iron deficiency anemia. We have seen this. Thalassemia shows shift to left. That is, it shows reduced osmotic fragility. Normally, hemolysis of 50% RBCs was occurring at what concentration of sodium chloride? 0.45%. Normally, we have done all this. Normally, hemolysis occurs at 0.45% sodium chloride. Hemolysis of 50% of the RBCs occurs at 0.45% sodium chloride. So in NESTROF, if I have to detect whether the patient has thalassemia or not, what concentration of sodium chloride will I use? Less than 0.45 or more than 0.45? Less than that. So in NESTROF, we use 0.36% sodium chloride. What I want to show is, at this concentration, normal individual will show hemolysis versus a patient of thalassemia, which will not show hemolysis of 50% RBCs. This is NESTROF, naked eye, single tube, red cell osmotic fragility test. So if I have to plot this, let us have a look at the first image. what you see here is this is nestrop. This is nestrop, in which we used 0.36% sodium chloride. Normal individual showed hemolysis. Hemolysis occurred. As a result, we are able to see black line at the back of the sample. Versus a patient of thalassemia, in which the no hemolysis of 50% RBCs did not occur. Why? Because of reduced osmotic fragility. So the black line at the back is not visible. It is not visible. This is nestrop. This is nestrop. Naked eye, single tube, red cell, osmotic fragility test. Please note, it is just a screening test for thalassemia, not the screening test of choice. Next point. Have a look at this image. Diagnosis. Pretty straightforward, easy one. I need not even say this, that this is peripheral smear. We are able to see RBCs in the background. Showing the presence of all these, which are sickle-shaped RBCs. These are the sickle-shaped RBCs. So diagnosis, sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia. What is this cell? This is a neutrophil. It's a neutrophil. What is this cluster that you are seeing and these individual ones? These are the platelets. These are the platelets. So this is a case of sickle cell anemia. This is a case of sickle cell. Next, diagnosis. A very important slide. Very important diagnosis. Be unbiased. What do you see here? This is a peripheral smear. This is a peripheral smear which shows marked, there is variation in size as well as shape. Some RBCs, they are smaller, some are larger with presence of target cells. You're able to see this. There is variation in size as well as shape of the RBCs. So peripheral smear shows marked anisopoikilocytosis. It shows marked anisopoikilocytosis with as compared to normal, the majority of the RBCs are smaller in size. With microcytic hypochromic RBCs, have a look at these. These are such small RBCs, microcytic hypochromic RBCs with what are all these which we are able to see? All these blue dots, what are they? Lymphocytes. Nahi bache. See, this is a microcytic RBC. This is a small RBC. As compared to this microcytic RBC, this nucleus thing is even smaller. Means it's not a lymphocyte. Lymphocyte should have been, it's equivalent to a size of normal RBC. It's much smaller than microcytic. Means it's not a lymphocyte. These are nucleated RBCs with numerous nucleated RBCs. You are able to see this blue thing is the nucleus. This blue is the nucleus with hemoglobinized cytoplasm. Every nucleated cell has cytoplasm around it. So marked anisopoikilocytosis with microcytic hypochromic RBCs with numerous nucleated RBCs. With what are these cells? These are RBCs with a central dot with target cells. With target cells. So peripheral smear showing anisopoikilocytosis, microcytic hypochromic RBCs, nucleated RBCs and target cells. Diagnosis, thalassemia major. Diagnosis, thalassemia major. This is an important slide. This slide was broken up into images and was asked last year, that is 2018 All India exam. I will be showing you that question. Not to worry. Done. So this takes care of our next hemolytic anemia, that is thalassemia.